Hello, I'm Joel Carpenter from the University of Queensland in Brisbane, Australia. And today I'm going to be showing you our lab where we work on the spatial manipulation of light.
This is my ride to work. This footage has not been sped up. That's just how fast I cycle. We're about to go over the Eleanor Chanel Bridge, aka the Green Bridge. It's a bike, pedestrian and bus bridge, and it's the main way we get to UQ from this side of the river. We're heading over the Brisbane River now, which snakes through the city. We're coming over to the UQ side of the bridge now, and if you're going to crash your bike, this would be the spot it's going to happen. And I'm safe for another day, it seems. Now we're going past the UQ Lake, which is outside the building we work in, and also outside the lab itself. And the building has the incredibly inspiring name of General Purpose Building South. We're pulling up out the front now, where we're greeted with the very on-brand bike rack, which is shaped like the letters UQ, which is great, except for the fact that you can't actually attach your bike lock to a letter U. But we think outside the box here at UQ, and crime is low in Brisbane, so I'm not going to lock my bike anyway, even if I knew how to. Entering the building, and my swipe card still works, which means they haven't fired me yet, and we're heading down to the first floor and into the photonics lab. This part probably looks broadly the same as any other optics lab anywhere else in the world. Bunch of optical tables, bunch of half-finished experiments on them, and a bunch of researchers too lazy to show up on Saturday morning to finish them, apparently. But an untraditional aspect of the lab is that it overlooks the lake, and it also overlooks a pedestrian walkway outside. It means from the lab we get a nice view of nature, but it also means that you get gawkers walking past, looking into the lab like it's some sort of science zoo in here. Next up, we'll go through the team that's working here on different topics, different projects in the area of spatial manipulation of light.
Hi, my name is Martin Bleichner, and I work on vertical cavity surface emitting lasers. What we're trying to do here is characterize the spatial, temporal, and spectral characteristics of these VCSELs, and we have a system here with an SLM that allows us to do that. And long term, we're planning to improve these characteristics to improve the speed of the VCSELs in telecoms.
My name is Marco Maestre. I'm working in multimode fiber imaging. This is the setup which I'm working right now. It's composed of a spatial light modulator we use to manipulate the light and inject the corresponding modes into the multimode fiber, like this one. After that, we can see we measure the output fields using digital holography, composed by the reference arm at the camera. Once we have these fields, we can measure the transmission matrix of the fiber and see through it, which means we can use the multimode fiber as an ultra-thin endoscope.
G'day, my name is Daniel Dahl, and I'm working on multiplane light conversion. Essentially, the whole basis of this device is it takes N spatial modes and converts them to N other spatial modes. So what we have here is an actual setup of the device. So a beam comes in through some custom optics and is bounced multiple times off of a SLM, which manipulates the phase of the beam. It then comes out of the system and onto a camera where we reconstruct it using digital holography. So what we have here is an actual reconstruction of LG modes that are coming out of the system.
Hello, I'm Mikael Munex. I've been a postdoc in the lab for the past 3 years. My research project is a collaboration with Nokia Bell Labs in the US, where we've created a new device called the Time Reverser, where we can generate arbitrary optical fields in space, spectrum, time, and polarization. This device can be applied for optical imaging, such as here, where we can scan a spot as a function of space and time.
I'm Joel Carpenter, and this is my setup. It's ostensibly a multiplane light conversion system with a digital holography characterization apparatus. I started setting it up about 3 months ago, and then I got distracted, and then I didn't come back to it. So all we've got is a spatial light modulator, some custom optics and metalwork here, with a beam path that doesn't actually go anywhere. We've got this partially mounted beam splitter and lens combo. And then we've got this InGaAs camera, which has just sort of been staring blankly at that wall for the past 3 months, like it's got PTSD.
If it takes forever,
I'll finish assembling you one day, set up. One day. There's just a few things I have to take care of first.
winters and summers, I will wait for you till you're back beside me, till I'm home.